So far, so good. And, yeah, we'll see how we go.
On to other news now. The Nurses Union has lost patience with the state government over the controversial Transforming Health rollout. It says the lack of meaningful information released so far is concerning, prompting an urgent meeting with the Health Minister in a bid to ease the tension. Angelique Dinellan reports.
An appointment with the Health Minister after spending a long time in the waiting room.
Look, we have been frustrated by the level of detail and the amount of time that has passed since the release of the Transforming Health agenda.
The Nurses Union decided to put pen to paper when a long-awaited document arrived last week that failed to provide the detail it was looking for. Under Transforming Health, the Repatriation General Hospital is to be shut and major surgery is planned for other hospitals such as Modbury. In its letter to the Minister, the union says for those employed at work sites being earmarked for relocational closure, the information contained in the latest document is manifestly inadequate and will do little to ease ongoing concerns over their future. It also demanded more information about bed and job cuts.
The Nurses Federation has been one of the stakeholders that have bent over backwards to give the government the benefit of the doubt to help them implement their plan. Now, 9 months in, they're blowing the whistle.
After a 45-minute meeting and some assurances, the minister and union kissed and made up for now.
They're not going to lose their job. We're not going to be out sacking nurses. That is simply something that's not going to happen.
Our plan from this point is to ensure that commitment gets transferred into a legally binding document.
The health minister concedes some nurses will have their roles changed under Transforming Health and beds will be cut, but only when patient flows through hospitals improve. Angelique Dinellan, ABC News, Adelaide.